You're still watching UBC News tonight. In our business stories, the testing of genetically modified potatoes for resistance against lead blight disease at Kachinkano Zono Agriculture Research and Development Institute has yielded positive results. After harvesting, the genetically modified potatoes have shown resistance to lead blight disease.
This is the harvesting of genetically modified potatoes being tested for resistance against potato late blight disease at Kachwekano Agricultural Research and Development Institute. The genetically modified potatoes were planted at the same time with non-genetically modified potatoes to compare the level of resistance against potato late blight disease. After harvesting, the genetically modified potatoes have shown resistance to potato late blight disease as well as improved yield compared to non-genetic ones.
I'm very happy with the results that we are getting because this is a transgenic plant. This is yield per plant. This is one plant where the plant has genes for late blight resistance. But you can see for this one, where there was no genes for late blight resistance, you can compare the yields. This is maybe like 40 times or even 50 times more than the plant that did not contain the genes.
Potato late blight disease affects potatoes by causing premature drying of leaves and can lead to 80 to 100% yield loss. The testing of genetically modified potatoes against late blight disease started in 2013 and has now reached fifth stage. The testing is being carried out in other countries like Kenya and Tanzania in collaboration with International Potato Center.
Where we are working in this region, that is Uganda, Kenya, Tanzania, Rwanda, Ethiopia, and what we are doing is we are trying to develop varieties that are climate resilient. You know, the climate is changing and we have new diseases. So for the field that we're working on is a variety that we developed that is resistant to late blight, which is a major disease in Uganda, causing a lot of losses. So this variety that we've developed, as you can see, doesn't get the disease and is going to be high yielding.
These genetically modified potatoes have now qualified for multi-locational trials in potato growing regions like Elgon and Jigezi. However, any genetically engineered agricultural material cannot be released to the farmers because the Genetic Engineering Regulatory Act 2018 has not yet been assented to by the president. But if the law on genetic engineering is operationalized, all genetic materials will be approved by the National Biosafety Committee before release to the farmers. Adia Nakuti and Clement Wanjira, UBC.
Great way to beat blight disease in potatoes. Moving on, it's now 2 years since Baraboro Village in Oyem was declared a climate smart village, and according to researchers, the concept is coming out. Before the launch of the climate smart technologies, the communities could hardly harvest from their gardens. The temperatures were very high. They can now harvest throughout the year. Take a look.